continue on with their Marvel Legends 6-inch series, Thanos Endgame Bath Wave. What a title. Over 6 inches tall for the 6-inch scale figure from this wave, number 1. Picked it up at DarkSideToys.com. Very well shipped and packed. If you like your figures in good nick, then that's the place to go. Link in the description underneath the video to go and buy it from them. Let's get a look at the packaging. Ronan is on the box, obviously Hawkeye inside, but to harken back to Ronan from the comic books. Nice artwork there on the side of the box for him. Avengers logo up at the top. On the back, some text if you want to freeze frame. Doesn't really tell you too much. Come on, camera, you're just being awkward today. There we go. And down at the bottom, all of these figures here get to build, apart from Cap, the Thanos Endgame Build-A-Figure. So there we go, we'll get on to that shortly. We'll give him a separate review, UPC should you need it, and that's pretty much the packaging. Nothing else to really show you. So the very first interesting thing about this figure before we go anywhere is you can use the head of this figure and make from the Target 2-pack and make a very nice Hawkeye, which I've discussed in a different review. This is from the Target Black Widow Hawkeye and Black Widow 2-pack. So yeah, it makes a very good, reasonably good with the hood figure, but very good kind of likeness for Ronan there with these mask off. So it's a nice figure to have. And even without that Hawkeye head, this really is a particularly good figure. You get a nunchucking throwing hand. It's not really essential, and I think we could have probably skipped it, but a nice little touch. Don't recall that in the movie. Did they do that? Maybe you did. It's basically reusing the bullseye kind of hand or method that they've had, whereby he throws the little cards or the daggers, whatever he's got, the little daggers. Doesn't really work for me, but again, it might work for you. Let me know what you think. Do you like it? I'd love to hear your thoughts and comments. If you're into that or not, but you can pop it out and get a working hand, a gripping hand, and off you go. So nice detail inside, lots of kind of gold, I should say, on this figure, and a lot of nice gold sculpted little parts and pieces on the figure. This is nicely done on the shoulders there, that gold. Don't remember there being quite as much gold in the movie, but there you go. The hood's nicely done too. All the stitching is really nice. Let me just zoom up the camera just a little bit there for you, and you can see, look at the detail on that sculpt. Look at the folds, the stitches. It's impressive work. They definitely do impressive work on the sculpts, but sometimes the paint can let them down. But this is pretty good. Looking a bit shocked in his face there, but he is about to slaughter some more people. But this easily pops on and sits underneath this hood, or this collar, I should say, and it kind of makes it behave quite well and doesn't look too kind of daft. Sometimes hoods, particularly on things like robes and Jedi, it doesn't really work very well. But this works pretty good. I do like it. It looks very good indeed. And of course, just pop that off if you don't want it on. And he's got his unmasked head. Now, a lot of people are going to be pissed that you don't get the Hawkeye head underneath, but that's why Hasbro get you to buy two sets of figures. So, there you go. So, head underneath, not bad. But, not really bothered about it, to be honest. It could be a faceless ninja. But I do like it. The gold works pretty well. Like, it's a shame none of the other pieces in the sculpt could really have been picked up. Little things that these kind of designs here and little pockets here and there, but I guess he is a kind of ninja character. So, yeah, we want to be slightly stealthy, don't we? Come on, camera. Knee pads, nicely sculpted again, and down to the shins down there, and even down to the boots. Nice. Oh, again, all sorts of really nice sculpts and movie accurate bits and bobs. It's very nicely done indeed. So the back has a kind of sword holder for two. Now, whatever way, there's no right way to do this. There will be another way from the movie, but we've not really had a chance to really see up close Ronan in much more detail, such as an art of book. But this holster on the back, or sheath, or someone will correct me if I'm not saying the right word, I'm sure. But it literally is pretty damn wide. So you can have a couple of blades in there. You can have them whatever way you want, quite frankly. It doesn't really. But It doesn't, looks a bit odd, and I've found, quite frankly, the easiest way to do it is have the blades as so. It kind of works a whole lot easier. Or do it that way. No, that doesn't work really either. So, yeah, there's no real right way to do this. I've not seen anybody say this is the way you should do it. So, it's your call. Either way, whatever works. And there you go. And he holds those blades pretty well. The grips are very good on the hands there. And that will rub off in the black paint, though. So the gold will eventually go. But he holds pretty well. And it's a pretty solid figure. Articulation-wise, we've got a ball joint hinge on that head. And again, fits the Hawkeye head. Plenty of free range and movement, no issues. Ball joints up at the top of the shoulders. And again, no issues on that either. Very poseable figure. Swivel joint at the biceps. Double joints at the elbows. You've got wrists that both rotate and go back and forth. You have underneath this upper torso, there is no ab crunch I can see. No, I don't think so. Is there? There might be actually underneath that. But we need to take that off and have a look. Ah, there we go. Little piece at the back. We do have an ab crunch. Da, da, da. So yes, you could take this off and have a bit of a faceless ninja. Underneath he's got his generic ab crunch going on there, which is pretty good. Swivel waist, pegs up at the top of the thighs. Up at the top, yep, top of the thighs, swivel up at the top of them as two, double joints at the knees, no boot cut, and rocking ankles and pec holes, pretty generous ones. So there you go, a couple of ninja looks. This one's going to be way sold out for sure. This is going to be the popular one, along with Ebony Maw, who's coming up next, so we'll show you him too and see what you think. But I love this Hawkeye, especially the fact you can get the swap out head. So like it. Let me know what you think now. That's the important thing. I'd love to hear, again, your thoughts and your comments. Leave them in the comments below and we'll get back to you. Thanks again to Dorkside Toys. You want to buy it? Link underneath. And we'll see you for the next review. See ya.